What's up? Wait. Why? Because I've been putting it off and I'm supposed to do it. What did we miss? My hair was dyed dark purple. Then I was like, I don't like this anymore. So I went full black. And I've had my hair black since I was a kid. And yeah. So I'm going to show you what I do in the process, because we're gonna speed run this. Normally you're supposed to leave it in your hair for like 3 hours, but we're gonna only do it for an hour. Why? Because I gotta work in the morning and I don't feel like washing my hair in the morning. Yeah, well, yeah. So, well, I probably should though. Never mind, I think I'm gonna leave it in for 3 hours, but I'm gonna show you the process. I'm gonna show you what I do. And I'm gonna stitch the video in, showing you how I make my oil, the process, and how it's been going. I'm gonna put pictures in here to show you how short my hair was when I first started oiling my hair versus now. So yeah, okay. Okay, the worst part in all of this is trying to figure out how to set up the phone, but we're gonna just leave it here and hope for the best. So, I'm gonna start out by right. So, oh brother, I'm gonna get a bunch of people saying, "Oh, first from the end, they go up." I don't give a fuck. Maybe I should give a fuck. This brush is the wet brush with the bore hair bristles.
What's that?
And the brush was $15 from, I got mine from Walmart, but I'm pretty sure you can get it from like Sally's or Target or something like that. But I have been using it for a couple months now and I think it's pretty good. I mean, it definitely smooths out my hair. As you can see. I don't have a mirror, so give me a second. As you can see, my hair's black. Box dye black, so like you can imagine. It's blue black from, I believe, Revlon. And honestly, it's pretty good. For a box day, it's definitely my first time dyeing it black, but what I do say is that it bleeds. Like, it doesn't matter how many times you, like wash it out or whatever. I don't understand why it bleeds the way it does, but it does. What I'm gonna do, and it's gonna be hard for me to show you, but I'm gonna explain it the best way I can. Sorry, I'm using the mirror. So I section my hair like this. There's only two, and then I kind of work it in. Let me get my other brush. I have a regular brush from, my girl, I can't even tell you. I'm pretty sure this one's from Walmart too. It's shit, but it's good enough to where I'm like, okay, whatever. This is a sample of the oil that I have. I say sample because I made it in like a jar and I pour it in here, because what do I look like bringing the whole jar up here? Right. So right now, as you can see, it has, I'll show you. It has like fresh rosemary and cloves. I have a rosemary tree, but you don't have to use fresh rosemary. I mean, you could. You could use store-bought rosemary, or you can use the dried ones. Doesn't really matter. And then I have a castor oil. Now look. Do not put this in your hair by itself. I don't know. Just don't. Because this, for some reason, hard to wash out. And I've heard that it's just not good for your hair by itself. Now, I don't really use the castor oil, but it already kind of has castor oil on it. I just use it for the dropper. I know. I should get one for just this, but I'm lazy and I don't feel like doing all that. I really was looking for the oiling brush. You know what I'm talking about? Anyway, I'm gonna put a picture right here. And I saw them like on Shein, fairly cheap, but then I was like, I like doing this stuff the hard way. Okay, I missed some steps. What you're gonna do before you put anything in your hair, you're just gonna take your hands, a brush, or let me show you, a little shower, hair, scalp scrubbers, and just gonna massage like your head like that, like that, to promote blood flow. I brush it straight back. Why? Because if I do this, knots everywhere. So you're gonna take this. I mean, the brush does the same thing, but this kind of gets it evenly, and it's easier to just go like that. You're gonna do that. Do it for a couple of minutes. Obviously, don't do it to where like your scalp is hurting, but blood flow promotes growth. And that's what we learned. And you can hear my ends crunching, but that's what that is. So definitely my scalp is physically hurting because I did it too hard just now. You're gonna separate your hair again as best as you could. Again, this is me doing it without a mirror, but you're gonna make sure that you're at least getting it on your scalp. Do not put it in the ends just yet. But you're gonna take a little bit, this much. You can rub it in your hands, that's what I do too. Unless you're lazy, and just, you can do that too. But you can't guarantee coverage like that. You're rubbing in your hands. I do it this way. You can do it however way you want. This is how I do it. It smells good. You can really smell the cloves. And then you're just gonna go like that. Make sure that it's in your scalp. You want to make sure that it's pretty much all over. Rosemary has growth properties, allegedly. And then I use cloves because I don't know if there's actually any properties for that. So for now, I'm gonna continue doing this, and then I'm gonna show you how I wrap it up, and then I'm gonna shower, and then I'm gonna show you the rest of the video, okay? So, 1 sec. Okay, so now that you look like you haven't showered in at least a month, this is what you want. But, okay, I put a dirty shirt on because if I got oil on a clean shirt, I'm gonna tweak because it stains. Sometimes I don't really care about this shirt, but so what I do from here is after I've pretty much applied it everywhere, it's like all over my scalp, kind of. You really just want it on your scalp because you want it to sit and let that simmer. But what I do is you can sleep with it overnight. You can wait 3 hours. I don't feel like doing that. I'm just gonna leave it overnight, and I usually put it in a braid, and I usually have like a shower cap I put on so I don't like get it wet because I'm gonna shower, and then I'll finish the video in the morning as well to show you like what it looks like when I wash it and take it out. It looks really good, like low key, but yeah, for right now, enjoy the clips of me making the oil. And yeah, enjoy that in the meantime, and we will catch back up in the morning. So this is what my hair looked like before I started oiling and doing everything. I also cut it like super, super short. Okay, so because I'm dumb and I thought that I recorded the process on how to make the oil, I did not. I just took pictures, so I'm gonna go try my best to explain everything.
As you can see, we have fresh rosemary, cloves, and olive oil. You can use whole cloves or ground, doesn't matter. From there, you see I have like a double boiler situation going on, so you're gonna start the water off in like a regular boil, and then you're going to wash and break up the rosemary into pieces and put that in the olive oil. Make sure that it does not overboil, because that would be bad. You don't want to like burn anything. So just let it simmer. Like, that's the best way I can put it, is simmer it. And then I usually put the jar in the fridge for about 3 days. Let it soak, let it do whatever. Obviously, I don't put it in the fridge hot. I let it cool down first, because, you know, it'll break if you put it in the fridge. But that's what I do for that. So do what you want with that information. So this is like the most recent picture of my hair, like literally the day before I made this video. And as you can see, it's just longer and it looks a lot healthier, shiny. Yeah, so.
Good morning. Well, kind of. But it's currently 1 o'clock. I have like an hour and a half left, so I have to work. I'm gonna wash this really quickly. But this is what this is supposed to look like under your bonnet slash hair cap slash cover, because I wasn't supposed to sleep with this like out, but I don't care. And now I have to wash my sheets, so I'm gonna show you how this looks styled, or like not styled, like washed and like the shine outside. And yeah, I hope you enjoy the videos I put in. And yeah, so I don't know. I'm just gonna show you guys what it looks like after it is. Okay, right.
Okay, so this is what my hair looks like now. After a wash, it's still kind of wet, but this is what it looks like. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. It was a mess, per usual, but I'm about to head to work, so I hope that you are having a good day. I hope that you ate, you're drinking water, you're getting out and getting active. Because why? Hot girl summer is approaching. Right. Sorry, that was the cutest bike. You know what? That doesn't matter. Sorry. I love motorcycles. But, other than that, I hope that you have a good rest of your time existing out in the world somewhere. So, yeah. Okay.